Reading from the book Child of God by Divaldo Pereira Franco and Spirit Joana de Angelis. Chapter 8, Forgive Yourself. The Gospel states that we should be indulgent with the faults of others, but strict with our own. To achieve self-illumination, we must keep a firm attitude of alert day to day, watchfulness over our own actions. When we understand that earthly life is intended to be an uplifting experience, it is only natural for us to learn a great deal through losses which will turn into gain because of the reaction they will create. Aware of such a reality, you must be tolerant with the faults of others, be indulgent within your social circle, and wherever you are. Although you must not accommodate to your own weaknesses, you should not be too harsh on yourself. When you fail, do not brood over your faults, and do not vitalize your errors by concentrating upon them. When you fall down, pick yourself up and start over again. You are an ever-unfolding soul, temporarily enrolled in the school of life. Each step forwards leads on to a higher level. If you're pleased with yourself and stagnate, you delay your spiritual liberation. If you become bitter and depressed because you have made a mistake, you will also hinder your march. But if you acknowledge your personal limitations and understand your own mistakes, you will find it easier to forgive others. When right, proceed. When wrong, forgive yourself, reconsider your actions, and move on. A loving person must love himself too. If you're tolerant with yourself, you will be stimulated to proceed along the spiritual road of progress, and your actions will be more and more efficient and your deeds nobler. Let's now calm down our minds and seek connection with our spiritual mentors. And today, specifically, thank Joana de Angelis for such important reminder. Let's not forget that yes, we must forgive our brothers and sisters if they err with us. But it's also very important to forgive ourselves, to liberate ourselves for such an easeful weight that we keep carrying at times. For centuries. Let's be compassionate with ourselves. Let's understand that we are beings in evolution and that we are still far from moral perfection. And at times, we will fail, but upon failing, we should reconsider why we failed and try once more to do the same thing in a different way, a better way. If we harm others, let's try to make up for our mistakes. Let's apologize. Let's try to make amends. If we fail with ourselves, let's try to do the same and make amends with our own consciousness. It is important to acknowledge our current state, our current evolutionary state. But in the other hand, let's not use the fact that we know that we are still far from perfection as an excuse to stagnate and do not seek improvement and overcome our moral imperfections. It is this balance between acknowledging what we are and having a goal of being better that makes us spiritists. The effort that we put into becoming better every day is what makes us Christians. Now, in silence, let's think of ways that we can improve ourselves and think of things that we think that we should forgive ourselves and others about. So now, once more, we thank you, dear Joanna, for this precious reminder of forgiveness. It is such a relief to drop this heavy luggage and continue our pathway towards perfection. So be it. Let's all have a peaceful night.